sleigh bells ringing, diamonds blinging, carols singing, famous season. Sleigh bells ringing, diamonds blinging, carols singing, famous season. They said, say, Nick, what you got up in that bag, yeah. I got racks, racks in my sack or in my back, yeah.
Happy Vlogmas, fam. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to All Things Pegi. If you're new here, I am Pegi. My honey bunny is Donald Bud. He's outside hooking up the RV because it is time to go. Like, I miss camping so much. I miss it. So right now, you can't, the places that we like to stay, and within like a couple hours drive or booked for the rest of the year. I should have known it, but I didn't want to bother because I didn't know what was going to go on with the RV. We don't know if it's going to be finished or not, but I was telling Donald, I'm like, well, let's just go up to the front office and talk to the lady to see if, you know, they could reserve us a spot. And then if we know that it's not going to be available, then we could call. Well, if the RV won't be ready, we could call and just cancel so somebody else can have it. But while we were in there, there was another older lady, and she's out here by herself, and she has like a Class B. And she's like begging if she could stay. And they were like, ma'am, we're booked. And they were like, we're trying to get the four spots open that had some trouble, but we have a waiting list. And she was like, oh, that's fine, I'm on the waiting list. And they was like, yeah, but you're pretty far down on the waiting list. And she was like, I have nowhere to go. She was like, what am I supposed to do? I felt so bad for her. It's just like, these winter months are hard, especially in warmer climate areas, to book for your RV. So I know next, like in June, I'll know to make my reservation for Christmas, because next year's Christmas will be in an RV in some kind of way. I don't know. I just want to find a really nice resort RV area to stay there. And I would love to do like a Christmas through New Year's, because I'm like, man, Jacksonville would be so much, it would be just nice if we could do it like the day before Christmas and stay to like, so if we could do it from December 24th to January 2nd, that would be so cool. So next year, I'm just gonna, you know, when June opens up, because they allow you to book 6 months in advance. So when June comes around, I'm setting my appointment in my phone right now, so that next week we will be on that resort from the 15th. Like, I want to stay there for 2 weeks. So from the 15th to January 2nd, and then we'll go on home. But yeah, so when we signed in, what day did we sign in? A couple days ago, we signed in. And she was asking us if we had any pets or anything like that. And we told her no. And she was like, well, because we had to put some poison out because we're having trouble with, what do you call those little things? Armadillos. We're having trouble with armadillos. She was like, they are everywhere. And she was like, they're not a threat or anything, but it's just so many of them. And so I noticed that when I was driving in, and I started to record it, and I don't know why I didn't. So I'm gonna see, it might be too early and too cold right now. But when we were coming in, like, you might see one, but when you see him, he's probably on his back with his legs up. That's sad. But I've never really seen one walk by while we were out here. But when we were coming in the other day, I want to say we saw like 7 or 8 of them just walking down the walking path, right? Because this lady was walking with her husband and her dog, and the dog was just going crazy trying to get at him. And I was just like, we're not going to go, because we were going to go try to bike ride, but the path is so little and it's kind of almost like a wooded area. And I just didn't want to have the problem, you know, because I'm scared of everything. Y'all know I'm scared of everything. I know armadillos are not going to chase my bike and knock me off of it or anything, but I just rather leave them alone. Like, I hope that they go to safety somewhere. But so we didn't really get out to get anything done. So we were just like our neighbors. We kind of stayed in and stayed ourselves. And so all in all, this, I'm going to call this trip a success, even though the next day we had to drive back home. But thank God it was only like an hour, 40 minutes to get back to the house. And so right now, Donald is packing everything up. But, you know, we needed this time so that we could sit inside the RV and write down the things that we wanted them to look at. And so our list is pretty, we got a nice size list. I don't know if they'll look at everything. I don't know if they'll say everything is covered, but I'm hoping for the most part that 80% of the list can be done, because some of that stuff, I mean, we probably have to figure out for ourselves, like what we can do. But I scrubbed the place down real good and got it together. I just felt like it needed to be cleaned for some reason. So I cleaned it real good. And I figure if while I'm cleaning, like you could check the RV while you're cleaning to, you know, see what else is wrong or what else is missing. And so I think we did a good job. I think we did what we were supposed to do. Now, the thing I don't like about Camping World is, like, they don't call to verify that you have an appointment. We've been trying to call them for 2 days. They have not answered the phone. So we're just going to go and we're just going to leave her. And that's that. Like, they just going to have to take her. I wish we would have took her back in Arizona, though, because they could get us in immediately in Arizona. So I don't know. We might have to drive a ways to get it done if these people... Because here they seem to be really, really crowded. Like when we were in Arizona, they was like, okay, bring it in, but we didn't. So, yeah. But anyway, guys, I want to do something to Donald because he gets on my nerve with his words. So we were having a conversation and I used the wrong word or the wrong variation of a word. And he loves to correct me. So when he get in his car, I'm going to use like words that I know don't fit what we're talking about, just to see how he going to handle it. Because he probably won't correct me because we're recording. But what he'll probably do is just laugh a little bit. Like Donald has a tail. His tail when, but you got to figure out what he's laughing at, but he has a tail.
Can you give me some hand sanitizer, please?
I would love to give you some hand. Oh, you let another fly in. Come on, player.
They're just waiting for us to open this door.
Yeah. We'll get it out.
Thank you.
We'll drive it out. He pretty big, though. Ooh.
Yeah, yeah.
Get out.
What's up, fam?
My honey bunny is busy. I'm sorry about that light, y'all.
There we go, so. Just trying to get this thing.
They checking around the park and stuff, all influential and stuff.
There we go. That's probably.
Didn't they look influential?
Influential?
Yeah. Those guys in that car. I couldn't think of nothing, y'all. Okay, so we're going to try it again. You hear that laugh? He has a tail. I'm telling you, like, when it's just me and him and we're talking, and if I do or say something that is not right, he can't help himself. He have to laugh. He just, but it's not, because it took me a while to get used to it. Because I'm like, why are you laughing at me? But him being the wordsmith, I have donned him the wordsmith. I have given him that title of being a wordsmith. And he's big on words because we'll be talking and he'll use a word that I had never heard in my life. And he'll be like, that's a good word. I'm like, okay, Dom. So I just want to give him trouble. So while we're driving, I'm gonna drive him crazy with those words. Just to see what he do. All right, y'all. That sun don't look right. It's kind of congruent to our faces. Why are you laughing? Why are you laughing? Why are you laughing? Look, this guy's laughing, talking to you.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, you?
I'm doing good.
Good. I didn't know if you noticed, it looks like one of your rear jacks is partly extended.
Oh, yeah. I appreciate that. It's like a little bit down. It don't always go matchable on both sides, but okay. I appreciate that.
So, I just want to say, I feel like you're using some big words this morning.
What?
I was just like, they looking all influential. I was like, wait a minute, it's like, oh no, they try like, the sun is like congruent to us.
What?
You trying to mess with me this morning.
Why would I do? Did I use those words right?
Yeah, no.
Yes, I did. Look, don't laugh at me, Donald. I'm trying to be serious.
Okay, I'm sorry, baby. I just thought you was messing with me and stuff.
That's I thought you were messing with me.
Look at
this. What? Why would I do that?
I don't know.
I was trying to sound all good for the family. Here you come laugh. Don't laugh.
I ain't gonna laugh. I'm not laughing.
Just, I mean, if I say something that don't make sense, just tell me to take it off. You know what I'm saying?
Did you mean like influential or intimidating when you said influential for the cop?
I don't know.
Looking all intimidating.
Maybe that's the word I was. It started with an I.
Yeah, it did. It started with INT.
See?
INF or whatever. IN. Anyhow. So we are hooked up, fam.
I guess my absurd behavior is just.
Okay.
I can't prank this man for nothing. I be trying so hard. I tell you, he has a tail. If he's talking to somebody, he laughed, that means that person has said or done something that doesn't really go together.
That was a prank?
Yeah. I just can't prank you. No. I was like, I have deemed you the wordsmith, and so I'm going to use all these crazy words to see if he'll catch on to it. I'll say, now he has a tail. His tail is he's going to bust out laughing.
And you sure told him that?
Yes. And I was like, it's sure enough. I got to work better. I'm going to prank him really good one time, for real. Like, I got to do it.
You try to be more vocabularical? Okay. All right.
Well, I'm glad you got your laugh on.
I saw, baby.
Another failed attempt at my hilarity.
It's hilarious, baby. That was beautiful. You got me laughing.
So, but you was laughing at me.
I was not laughing at you.
See, it's a difference of somebody laughing with you than at, you know what I'm saying? Like, I can tell if you laughing with me. See that laugh? See that laugh? He has different ones. All right, fam. We will see you, I guess, when we drop her off.
In the next clip.
Then you fall back, giving me signs that I've seen before. Yeah, it's cute, but honey, I want more. Don't waste no more time, no. There's no use playing hard to get. I figured you out, but you don't know what yet. So take off your mask, yeah.
Dropping her off at Camping World, and I don't feel too confident that we're going to get her before Christmas. Ooh, Donna.
You ain't good, baby.
Probably good right there.
So there are quite a few RVs ahead of us, but it looks like they got a pretty good system over there working, but I'm counting, and I stopped at 30. So hopefully we'll get her by January, but like I say, as soon as I get her out of the shop, we're gonna take her on the road. I want to just be gone for a couple weeks, just hanging out. If we can get some, well, let's just say as soon as we're able to get a reservation and she's out of the shop, we're gonna go ahead and take her for a spin. The guy just told Donald, he was like, we probably gonna find 50, 60 things. He was like, so what we're gonna do is just, we're gonna go ahead and do a courtesy evaluation, or I don't know what they call it, but they're gonna just go over the RV and look at everything.
Seems really, really interested in helping out. Courteous.
Ooh, customer service. What?
Exactly.
We got customer service.
We got a little bit of customer service. He said, hey, it does me no good holding on to your RV longer than we have to. We'll try to get this thing back to y'all as soon as possible. Get y'all back in these RV streets.
He didn't say that.
He didn't say that. But he was like, yeah, we're going to get it back to y'all as soon as we can. And any questions, you'll have my number from now on, even when you get back on the road. So I'm the liaison between you and the warranty company. I'm gonna be your personally assigned service manager.
So can I ask why we just didn't go straight? You gotta go inside.
I gotta back in and go inside.
Oh, okay.
Pass sign and stuff. Okay. Yeah, we just did the inspection and stuff. So he saw everything we had. Mm. He thought the window screen would be an easy fix, but he's like, "Yep, you're right. It is broken."
That's funny. I'm hungry.
I won't be here no more than 8 minutes.
Look at that Class B. But
I was looking at that Class A right there, that Berkshire. I was gonna ask them to get a price on that before I left.
Well, why don't you?
I will. BRB.
All right, player. As soon as they get this RV fixed, I just want to go. But we got to be able to go somewhere. Like, I don't want to go. Like, I know we could get, like, cold areas, you know, places that are not really warm, but I don't want to go somewhere and just be cold. I want to go somewhere where we could get out and do something. Somebody was telling us about some other campgrounds that
they gotta type up everything, so it might be 15 or 20 minutes. So I brought you a coffee. It might not be good as their, it's Camping World coffee, it's not Donald coffee, but
you're such a good husband.
It might be longer than we expect. That's why I brought it to you.
Thank you, sweetheart. Yeah, I see my husband. He brought me some coffee. We haven't eaten breakfast yet, and it's 11:30. And I haven't had warm coffee in like 2 days. So he's such a sweetheart. I'm telling you, God did bless me with a good man. I appreciate it. Oh, this coffee is good. I haven't had warm coffee since I discovered that iced coffee. Oh, my goodness. Oh, that's so good.